Hey guys, hope you are all fine. Today I'm going to talk about the power of knife tool. Knife tool is a really powerful and useful tool which is neglected by most of the artists. It is used to cut and add some edge loops on the faces of the mesh. So in this tutorial, I'm going to tell the basics of knife tool so that you may know how to use it, and then I will give you an example how you can achieve such looks for a building. So let's get started. First, select the mesh. And in edit mode, press K key on your keyboard to select the knife tool. And you will see a knife icon which will appear on your screen. Or you can go to the toolbar on the left side and press this icon to select the knife tool. Now if you click and drag left mouse button, you will see a purple line and will see a green dot which will appear on the edge of the mesh. This green dot are vertices which will be applied later to the mesh. So now you just need to click and drag to plan where you want to have edges. When you are done, just hit enter to apply these edges on the mesh. But if you rotate the mesh, you will see that the edges are only applied to the front side of the mesh. So if you want to have edges on both sides of the mesh, press K, and then you can see on the bottom of the interface it shows press Z to cut through. So if I press Z, it will show that it's on. And now if you click and drag across the mesh, you will see more green dots because now it's using the edges to cut through the mesh and make it appear to the back side of the mesh. And when you are done, just press enter. You can also click and hold on the knife tool to have bisect tool, and after that when you will click and drag towards the mesh, you will see an edge loop crossing over the mesh. You can also use the arrow to manually adjust the edge loop, or you can use the dialog box to use values for moving or rotating the applied edge loop. You can check clear inner to cut to remove inner side of the edge, and clear outer for the outer side. Check fill to add face to the deleted polygon. As an example, I'm using these two panels of the building. If you want to know how I created them, you can click on the above link. Then select the mesh, and to select the front face of the mesh, press the L key and use select by seams in the bottom left dialog box. Then separate the mesh and extrude it back to give thickness to it. Now just invert the selection and hide the window panel. Then just delete the inner side of it as we already have it. After that, just unhide all. Make sure to calculate the normal of the wall so that you don't have inverted normal map for the brick texture. Then just select the outer side of the wall and apply the concrete material that we have used before for the corner mesh. Then just like before, I have used the follow active quad and made UVs for the outer side of the mesh. If you want to cut the building bricks in edit mode, use the knife tool and make sure that you have enabled the cut through option and start to cut the brick from front side. All you need to do is just follow the brick's outer line and trace it as much as you can. Then just select the faces from every side and delete them. After that, just select the top edge of the mesh and press F key to fill till it reaches the end edge. Then you will need to select the faces and apply the material there and redo the unwrapping. You can also make detailed buildings by using the knife tool and trace out any of the building bricks and just duplicate it and then use the insert command and move it out. Then just hide the brick and dissolve the edges to have less poly count. You can do this for several bricks to have more depth to the building. This technique is really useful to make LODs for the game assets. You can duplicate and change the brick location to make it look like it's extruding from the side of the window panel. I will recommend you to create more bricks from the knife tool rather than just duplicating a single brick, as it will give more variation to the panel. Otherwise, anybody can spot the same brick across the model. If you want to have damage effect on the edge, then use the same knife tool, and this time make sure whenever you give an edge to a side, you will need to give the same number of edges to the other side so that later you can connect them. You can do that by selecting the two vertices and press the J to join them. Then select the middle edges, just ignore the two end vertices that are opposite to each other, and press two times the G key to slide the edges to one of the corner. In this way, you can have a damage effect. Later, you can apply the same concrete material and unwrap it again. Now select the top arc design and cut it through and delete all the middle faces that are present between them. Then just like before, fill the faces by selecting the edges and pressing the F key. When you are done, you can slightly rotate both of them. One more thing, you can use the knife tool to give effect of damage window shades. All you need to do is add two edges in the middle of the window shade and move the vertex down to distort the texture. You can also use it to give damage look to the window glass, but I use alpha maps if I don't want to give a shattered look to it. After that, just slightly rotate both of the window panel. It will create an effect that they are stuck or can't be used anymore. Now select any edges of the arc design and bevel it slightly. Do the same to the window frame as well. If there are less edges, then use the knife tool to apply more edges to it. For creating cracks, make zigzag line on the mesh, but you will need to have exact same edges near and parallel to it. After that, you will need to add edges in between them, which will be also connected to their vertices so that you can move them in and give depth to the cracks. You can repeat the same steps to give more branches to it. Then I have deleted the side mesh panel. Now duplicate and position the mesh to its side. You can also use Ctrl M for mirror command to flip the mesh. Then I have duplicated the side corners and use them in between the panels to create variation for the building. And use the same method for making cracks and filling them up. In the end, I have lowered down the reference value to give right look to the bricks. The same goes for the window glass. And that's pretty much about it. Hope you guys like it. If you like my tutorial, then subscribe and support me on Patreon, where you will be able to get the project files that I have used in my tutorials. Thanks for watching.